They said, we need extra security because the disciples are going to come in the middle of the night and they're going to steal the body of Jesus Christ. That's their reasoning. But I find fault with that, because up until this point, the disciples had proven that they wouldn't bust a grape in a fruit fly. Y'all praying with me? The disciples had already illustrated that they were not at the point of faith to even risk attempting to come to the Roman tomb to break the seal and try to take Jesus out of the tomb. So I believe that the Pharisees and those who were the Roman officials, I believe that there was another reason that they wanted security. I believe the reason was is that they heard some stuff. Some stuff had gotten back to him. This crazy man said, in 3 days I will rise again. And had not some stuff gotten back to him, they might not have believed him. But because there was some stuff preceding what he said, they had to think about what was happening. Some stuff got back to him. Some stuff like how he healed diseases that had otherwise went unhealed, it got back to him. Stories of how people did not have enough money to pay their taxes, and he went down to the river, told them to get some fish, and in that fish there would be some money to pay your taxes. The word got back to him. Some stories of how he spoke to the wind and the waves, and even the wind and the waves ceased when he spoke. Stuff got back to him. Some stories of how he supernaturally fed people who were hungry when there was not even enough, word got back to him. Stories of how he called demons out by their name, stuff got back to him. And I suggest that their fear was that they had seen too much of what he was capable of doing. And somewhere deep in their consciousness, there was a fear that maybe on the third day, he will get up just like he said. Though they might not have understood the resurrection prophecy, there was some other stuff that went down that they could not understand. And I don't think they were scared about the disciples. I think they were worried about Christ doing some other stuff. Right. What are you saying? I'm saying this. That the stuff in your life that's going on, I figured it out. It's not an attack against your person.
Okay.
It's an attack against your potential.
All right.
I wish I had somebody. I wish I had somebody who believed this morning that I got a lot of stuff coming out of me, not because I'm anybody special right now, but what has happened is that the enemy has began to get cautious because the enemy has seen some snippets of what God can do when he's working through me. The enemy has seen some snippets of me coming out of my deathbed and getting back right. The enemy has seen some snippets of me coming out of some hard stuff. The enemy has seen some snippets of me defeating some Goliaths in my life. The enemy has seen some snippets of me overcoming mountains and making it through valleys. The enemy has seen me survive tears that everybody else thought would never stop falling. The enemy has seen me survive letdown after letdown, disappointment, and then after disappointment. The enemy has seen me overcome some unfavorable odds in my life. And now the enemy is asking for extra security because the enemy is scared that if I keep going, there'll be something else growing out of me that the enemy will not be able to contain. I wish I had somebody that knew and believed in the power of their potential, that who I am is not where I'm going to be, that God has a lot more, much more for me going on. Don't judge me right now by where I am, but watch my potential.
Yes.
And so when they thought about the potential, they go to Pilate and they said, we need more security. It was already a stone, but they needed more security. So they go to the tomb. Pilate says, go to the tomb. Not only have the stone, but seal the stone. Seal the tomb. Take the necessary ropes and secure the tomb in to make it impossible that anybody would get in.
All right.
And if that isn't enough, keep a guard right there.
All right.
And you know what? When they walked away from the tomb that night, They thought they had done everything they could. They thought what they had done was enough. They were secure when they left the tomb that night, that when they came back in the morning, that there would still be a body right there. They had put all the necessary locks on the tomb. They had crossed every I and T and dotted every I on the tomb. But what they did not realize is that they were fighting a power that they had not fought before. I wish I had somebody in here to understand that they had no time to prepare for what was going in the tomb. I don't care how big you are. I don't care how many nuclear bombs you got. I don't care how much PT you have. I don't care how much field training you have. What was happening is that now they were facing a power that they had never seen before in their life. And when God saw them putting the seal on the tomb, when God saw them putting a guard by the entrance, I can hear God saying this. Nice try. Nice try. When you can take it two ways, you can take it in a nice way. It simply says you did your best, you gave your best effort, but your effort was still not enough to succeed in what you were trying to do. Or if you really want to be snarky, you can say nice try, and you can make fun of people who were trying to come after you, trying to get you, but their efforts did not succeed